Hello friends, good morning, and today we are completing our chapter, only last one topic which I'm going to discuss with you, then our chapter will be. What is the topic? Topic is the conclusion, what we have done in this chapter. Okay, this is only that. Now, the progress of Indian economy during the first 7 plants was impressive indeed. Our industries become far more diversified compared to the situation at independence. After independence, our country faced so much problems, and during that time period, our planners started some planning for the development of our country. And for that purpose, we have also involved in the developing policies, agriculture, industry, and service sectors. All are planned by the government sector, and government sector had removed some government started some policy, and with the help of this policy, land reforms and industries related new challenges accepted by the government, and our government has decided some plans for the revolution of land, revolution of the problems which occurred in the industrial sector, and to increase and provide more and more opportunity to the needy people for the employment. That's all we have faced. Land reforms also started by the government, and land reforms resulted in abolition of the hectic jamidari system, marwari system, and redwari system. You know friends, there's three type of policy started by the government for their Britishers, for their own purpose, for their own benefit. There's three systems for in the land, and for the agriculture, these are jamidari, redwari, and marwari. This all system changed by the Indian new government after 1947, when our new government has established, and they started their own policies, and due to that reason, so many land reforms also done. As a result, abolition of the hectic jamidari system also, and in industry sector, many economists become dissatisfied with the performance of many public sector enterprises. Excessive government regulation prevented growth of the enterprises and entrepreneurship also. Our government has started, and in the name of the self-reliance, Indian producers were protected against foreign competition. Mostly for this purpose, our government has intention for the protect of our Indian all industries, because that time our Indian industries were not ready to accept the challenge and competition with foreign countries' companies. Due to that reason, our government has decided to provide protection to our Indian industries against foreign competition. And for that purpose, so many support and encouragement given to Indian industries. Indian policies were involved, oriented, that failed to develop a strong export sector. So government has started new policy, and according to that, a new commodities can be produced in our India only, which will be replaced on this imported commodities. Which commodities imported in India, this commodity which are produced in India, this commodity will be replaced on that. That means import replace commodities produced by Indian industries. And it is very essential to give, during that time it was very essential. But from 1991, so many new economic policy also started, economic reform started by Indian government, which we will discuss in the next step. Okay friends, and next one is the exercise which you have complete or maybe completed. I already given instructions during my chapter explanation. You have to complete this one also. Friends, I have completed 2 chapters. So friends, please, please you complete this both chapters in your notebook. If you are not completing, then your fault. I am not in that fault. I already given these instructions. You have to complete your assignment. First one chapter, when I complete, then only I say it. After that also I say it. I repeat it many times. If you are following this all instructions, you will not increase your burden. Otherwise, in the last, you have lot of burden, and what work you have to complete, you have this question only. So friends, please you complete this and previous chapter related all exercises questions in your friend notebook, in economics notebook. Whenever we will meet, I will check this all, and you can send by the PDF file also on my personal contact number. Okay, and now we are discussing the next chapter. The next chapter, before that you have to read one time this all questions. If you have any query, please send a message. Define a plan. Why did India opt for planning? And why should plants have goals? What are high yield variety seeds? What is market table surplus? We all have completed this all answers. No one new and no one other question. This all we have completed. This only are given here. Explain the need and type of land reforms implemented in the agriculture sector. What is the Green Revolution? Why was it implemented? And how did it benefit the farmers? Explain in brief. Explain growth with equity as a planning objective. Does modernization as a planning objective create contradiction in the light of employment generation? Explain. Why was it necessary for a developing country like India to follow self-reliance as a planning objective? What is sectoral composition of an economy? Is it necessary that the service sector should contribute maximum in GDP of an economy command? That means both sides we have to write, negative and positive both we have to write here. And why was public sector given a leads role in industry development during the planning period? This one we have completed in my previous lecture only. Next one is, explain the statement that Green Revolution enabled the government to process sufficient food grain to build its stocks that could be used during times of shortage. And next one is, while subsidies encourage farmers to use new technology, they are a huge burden on government finance. Discuss the usefulness of subsidies in the light of its fact. This fact. That means you have to write this all positive points here. For the burden, the subsidies which go given by the government to the needy farmers, how it is increasing the burden for the government finance. This topic also we have discussed. Why, despite the implementation of Green Revolution, 65% of India's population continued to be engaged in the agriculture sector till 1990. Last one question is, 16 number question is, true public sector is very essential for industries. Many public sector undertaking incur huge losses and are a drain on the economy's resources. Discuss the usefulness of public sector undertaking in the light of this one. 17th number, explain how import substitution can protect domestic industry. Import substitution, which we are importing from the other country, same type of commodity produced in our India, how these are protecting the domestic industry. Why and how was private sector regulated under the IPR 1956? And next one is the match the following. Prime Minister, what option is correct? Friends, in this we have to match these both columns. First one is the Prime Minister. Its correct answer is C, Chairperson of the Planning Commission. Gross domestic product. Its correct answer is the monetary value of all the final goods and services produces within the economy in 1 year. Third, quota. What do you mean by the quota? Quota is the quantity of the goods that can be imported. Land reforms. Land reforms, that means improvements in the field of the agriculture to increase its productivity. HYV seeds, high yield variety seeds. These are, it's a correct match side is, match point is the A. Seeds that give large proportion of output. Sixth number, subsidy. What do you mean by the subsidy? The monetary assistance given by the government for production activities. You can take a screenshot and according to this only you have to write in your notebook. Okay friends, now we are going to start the next chapter. In the next chapter we will discuss about the 1991 reforms. Okay friends.